You must say all praises and honor unto your how, but
Hashem,
double honors to the apostles and unto the elders in our graven stone. Shalom to all the brothers out there, you know, pushing the truth in all sincerity and all honesty. Yeah, this is a brother from the James, Jamaica camp. Yashamai.
I war.
I know, and you know, do I'm a listen, right? You know, your apostle, you know, this year I'm the year of hopeful, all the prophecies, you know, fulfilled, right? And that's basically, you know, hoping for this year. Right? That hopefully we don't see another year in Babylon. Because, you know, the society, right, is basically, you know, corrupt, right? Very wicked. The society. And we want basically to flee this place here. So hopefully this year the last year we're living in this society. Right? But we don't understand and we know that, you know, in order to basically make it on the other side, we're going to go through a lot of things. A lot of temptation, a lot of tests, right? As we go closer, you know, and closer to the end of this year, this new year we're living in, things are going to get, you know, worse because we're going to get more temptation, right? With all the times ahead, right? Going back to late last year, we have a lot of articles coming out, you know, speaking about 2023, right? The hiking of food price, the blackout and all these things. So we know that this year, that will be a normal year, right?
Young woman. Second Ezra 14 and 13. If no food, no therefore set thine house in order,
God,
and reprove thy people, come forth such of them as be in trouble,
God,
and no renounce corruption.
Ah, renounce corruption. So we're supposed to set us house in order. God. So I started with ourselves first.
Right?
We have set ourselves, you know, in the right mindset. I get ourselves in the right mindset, especially, you know, in the time we're living in right now. Right?
Such as them
can
be in trouble,
and
God
gets
up. And the scripture said, in the days of trouble are at hand.
Can.
See, and all the way you're going to face it. Your brothers will have a stronger mindset. See, your brother will stronger in faith, your brother weaker in faith. See, so, this video is to serve as an exhortation to brothers out there, man. See, because that's what we have to do in these times, because troubling days are ahead.
Can.
So, we have to actually. Comfort such as being in trouble,
God.
As ourselves also, and we are comfort each other through the Spirit and for the Lord Yahweh Shai.
Yahweh Shai say, must send us a comforter, which is basically, it's true to us, it's where we have.
Right.
So we're supposed to comfort each other, because in the idea we don't love each other, right? The why long is only us we have here.
Right.
Because when things start to get real serious, you know, all our families, you know, so-called friends, they're going to draw from us. Right? Are we actually living that time now? When he saw Edom going to basically, you know, persecute, you know, men of the Lord. Because the scripture tell us about, you know, what happening, what basically take place in the future. Right? John Allen of Patmos, right? And saw, you know, certain men were going to get put to death for this truth. Right? So when things start to get real serious, any idea, you all the family members and your so-called friends you have in the world, they're going to turn, a lot of them going to turn them back on you. Right? So, don't go to each other. So as the brother mentioned, we're supposed to comfort each other, right? My brother? Oh, yes, 8 and 50.
The second is 8 and 50.
Yeah, go on.
It's for many great miseries shall be done to them that in the latter time shall dwell world.
Done. So say, many great miseries have been done to them in the latter time.
Done.
Right, in these times we're living in the last days of the last days we're living in right now.
Done.
Right? A lot of chaos are up on the earth like never before. You know, more and more you see things, you know, happening.
Right.
Right. We have to continue speaking about the MOTB because it's a major prophecy. Right, I can't do Elon Musk. By the next 6 months they're supposed to roll out them you know, them brain device. You know, that's a part of the prophecy where John saw also, right, going back, you know, on the island of Patmos.
Right.
Where John saw all these things. So we see all very closely right now.
Move
so Esau is making move in order basically, you know, these prophecies fulfilled. Yeah. Right? So very close right now because we see the things that the scripture speak about that play out, but in real time, in real life.
Right.
Right? As scripture says, St. John 6:63, it is the spirit that quickeneth. Yeah? The flesh profited nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and life, and they are life. And now we've seen that. Right? So we see the moves I make right now, the CBDC thing, how Esau we can move right now in order for basically bringing this thing fully. Right, which is a framework for the MOTB, so we're very close right now. Right, and as we go closer and closer, things gonna happen, you know, to us, to us more and more. We're gonna get a lot of trials, a lot of temptation, things gonna come.
We're gonna be plaguing at the mind. Can. A lot of things are gonna plague our mind, man.
Can.
See? Hey, even towards each other, as brothers, man, you're gonna have things that gonna plague our mind, man. See? Because it's a part of the test for the Lord, Yahweh gonna put upon us, man.
Can.
Because we have to get tested. As it is
proven,
they are tested to be proven. Yeah? As it is written, a friend cannot be known in adversity. And enemies can,
a friend cannot be known in prosperity.
And enemy cannot be in adversity.
Right.
So we are reached that time, so we are going to know who actually our friends, man.
Right.
Whether in that is true. The scripture says, you know what? Comfort, as we said before, comfort them those that are weak. Then, verse 51, but understand thou for thyself and seek out the glory for such as be like thee.
Can. Right, kind of idea is all about the elect.
Can.
Right, we know we hope we're part of the elect. Right, super say, many are called, but few are chosen.
Can.
So we hope we're part of that number. We're going to get delivered from all these things to come. Right, because this is the only thing we really have right now.
Right,
this is the only thing that really truly makes sense to us right now. This truth what we have right now.
Done.
Right?
First Peter 4 and 1 says, For as much then as a Mashiach art suffer for us in the flesh,
can.
Arm yourself likewise with the same mind. See?
Can.
For he that art suffered in the flesh art ceased from sin.
Can. Right, so as much as Yahweh Shai suffer for us. In the flesh, we're supposed to arm ourselves in the same mindset.
Yeah.
And you look for all the things that we always try to go through. Right, going back 2000 years ago. Right, and we are following off your house shy. Right, so we're supposed to try to get yourself in the same mindset. Your house shy suffer, right? We're going to suffer also. Right, you have a scripture. Yeah, oh yeah, you have a scripture, you know, speak about the house shy say, the servant is not greater than his master. Right? So we're gonna basically go through things also. Right?
Revelation 2 and 10 it says, fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life.
Done. So we're supposed to be faithful unto death no matter. You know what come our way, right? We're supposed to be faithful unto death. You know, ask the Hammer Bash shall give us that faith, right? You know, basically endure the death, right? Regardless if we have to go through, you know, certain things, even if I even put to death or torture, right? The Heavenly Father, Hammer Bash shall give us that spirit, right? As a brother, I bring up a scripture. I remember what happened going back during the time, you know, Judith, in the book of Judith, but then how our time. If you want to help them at the time, I'll give over to Elo Furnace,
yeah.
Right? The captain of Nebuchadnezzar.
Can.
Right?
Yeah.
Temple, the how about Shemir Shai? Right?
If you come to serve the Lord, they prepare yourself for temptation.
Can.
See? As, you want to bring out this Judith?
Yeah, man, you can't lick it. Yeah, you can't find
it. So we're going to try, man. We have to exhort brothers, man, because hey, things that can happen, different things that can happen to different brothers.
Can.
So we hard up with us. Being at the mindset, we say, boy, anything can happen to anyone when the time comes. See, we don't know who we're going to the concentration camp. See, we don't know who we're going to escape. We don't know who the Lord has spiritual power.
Right.
See, so all of these things, man. So we have to prepare our mind. See,
right.
Said, when the Lord said, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I'm just going to go quick. Revelation 3 and 10 says, because thou hast kept the word of my patience,
God.
I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth.
Now we're approaching a time right now, right, when Esau, you know, going to make the this MOTB become mandatory worldwide, okay. Right? In order for you to survive, you have to take that device, right? But how about Shemir Shai make a way to escape? Yeah. One and only way to escape, a matter of fact. So because people tell us that, right, in the time of, you know, the time of famine, we're going to be satisfied. So there's basically hope for us to escape Esau's trap. We must prepare right now, you know, set to catch the whole entire earth, because when this MOT become mandatory worldwide, right, in order for you to survive, you have to give in. But the scripture tell us there are another way, right? I know the average people are majority, are two-thirds of people, they're going to give in, because we already seen an example of what to come from 2020. You know, when this thing started and then we start rolling them, you know, them, you know, the serpent juice, and you know, see a lot of people start to run to take it all. Who would have leak out? You know, the most talk. A lot of people we even know we make the most talk, so they now go feed. Yeah. Them run go take it, yo. Right?
Some of the boldest people are more. So, them, so, them have the strongest mind and the strongest thoughts in them head, man. Them say them now do it. And some of them seem people. That's why you can't, if it's not men of the truth or men of the circle, man. You know, we're not supposed to trust nobody outside of the circle, man. See?
Right.
That mindset we're supposed to have. That's why the scripture says, seek out such as be like
to thee.
Gone.
Yeah, yeah. Seek out the glory for such as be like thee.
Gone.
See? It says, you want the Judith? Yeah. All right. We start. Judith 7 and verse 23. Point the 27.
Yeah.
It says, then all the people assembled to Zias and to the chief of the city, both young men and women and children, and cried with a loud voice and said before all the elders, God be judge between us and you, for ye have done us great injury, in that ye have not required peace of the children of Ashur. See? It says, for now we have no helper, but God had sold us into their hands.
And so,
Assyrians.
Yeah. The Assyrians, yeah, yeah. You know, yeah. Going back to the time, you know, you have in the Nebuchadnezzar.
Yeah.
You have the Assyrians, them, you have the Captain Elephernus. And Esau, we show you how much Esau, you know, hate. You know, so scripture says you have a perpetual hatred. You are the one
who kept
it right forever. You are the one who convinced the captain, you know, how to basically, you know, take us down. But then, we show you Esau hatred.
They see the history. Babylonian.
Yeah, yeah.
The same thing as him.
Yeah.
The rulers of the Babylonian Empire were the same.
Assyrians.
That's the reason why I said, behold, the wings were plucked.
Right.
You know? Like a lion and the wings were plucked. Right. Because it basically started off as the Assyrian Babylonian Empire.
Gone. Esau was always there, man.
Gone.
See?
Yep.
Sure, this man have nothing to pay for when to us here.
Gone.
And they're going to pay.
Definitely.
Right?
Even that time, Esther. That time, Esther. That Amman.
Oh, Amman,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, that same
Amman.
Same
Amman.
Yeah. It says, for now we have no helper, but God has sold us into the hands that we should be thrown down before them with thirst and great destruction.
So this is an example, you know, of basically what to come. Because if I say whatsoever thing was written aforetime was it for our learning. So going back during the time of the Assyrian basically captivity, right, with the Amisa, you know, till Elephernus of cut off the water, so people dead from basically thirst. Right? In the time to come, we're going to go through what? The hour of temptation, according to what written in the scripture.
Right, man.
He said, no man are going to buy yourself, save ye that has got karagma. Right? So Esau is going to make this thing mandatory, but we have to have basically faith.
Faith, man.
Right? No matter what we have to go through, we have to have that faith. And I think I have a lot of faith in order to go through during the time. Big faith.
Just so without faith, it's
impossible, possible to please it.
Please,
so these things are written for our learning today. Yeah. Understand that we're supposed to basically tempt the Lord, because I tell you right now. I give the Lord a time, fit. You know, even help, yeah.
Yeah, give the Lord a ultimatum,
man. Right, even help you that time, I'll give over.
Yeah.
Right?
You have certain even people out here, more than them, call. If you know them, call upon them false God, Jesus. See? But anything then come on, God have to do it. You see it? You know, in them churches? Yeah. That's not the mindset you're supposed to have. Yeah? You're supposed to humble yourself before the Lord. See? Because if actually, I'm saying I'm going to put you through the test. See? Prove who will be. See? And he's saying he's not going to give us no the temptation that which above would be not strength. Yeah.
Good.
See?
What?
We have the mindset. It says, now therefore call them unto you and deliver the whole city for a spoil to the people of Alfernus and to all his army. See? For it is better for us to be made a spoil unto them than to die for a thirst.
God, so that's our mindset, you know, Jacob then.
No faith.
Faithless. That's good for to our people, like, faithless generation. So you're going to take a lot of faith in the time to come to make it through all these things.
Yeah, because fear the man when they must see.
God, which is right, man.
You know, the Lord said, I am he that I'm guided you are those that you're afraid of a man that should die.
God.
You know?
He says, for it's better for us to be a spoil, they just give up their life and go to that, go dead. Yeah. The man then goes up, boom.
A slaughter.
Take what they have and slaughter, man.
Yeah.
See?
Got a thirst.
All the things when the Lord put them through to come from Egypt coming up and then see the great miracles where the Lord work for them. Man. Them still not have that faith. See? It says, made a spoil unto them than to die for a thirst. See? For we will be his servants that our souls may live and not see the death of our infants before our eyes, nor our wives, nor our children to die. See? And the times are come again, man. See? But let a lot of men, see? We say, even have men in Israel, we say them are Israelite right now, I say them in our truth. Basically, a lot of men are going to give in away, man. When them see hard times come.
And they mention about what the infant. Yeah. So that's not one of the weakness
we use.
Even your woman will basically try to use again, so you need to make her give in and to give the device in the time to come, because children are going to hunger. You know, so children can't really be hungry like that.
Yeah.
Children are the woman. So it's going to take a lot of faith, right? In order to make it through all these things, because you know, if you put everything aside, right? Scripture says, he that cometh to me.
Good.
And yet not mean disregard mother, father, sister, brother. Right? And you go down and say if your whole life, so you have to disregard all these things. Right? Because you're gonna reach that time. And if your family member, right, they will try to encourage you if you go and take that device. Right? Because they trust in this society, they don't see no other way up. Right, but we see another way. This is the way of Yahweh by Hashem Yerushalayim.
Right,
we've been speaking about these things for years, and now we're in a time now when Esau is putting things into place fast for these things come in order for these prophecies to come to pass. Right, years upon years we've been speaking about it, so we're going to get tests on all these things, especially the MOTV in the time to come. We've been speaking for years about right the whole of temptation in scripture I speak about. Go on,
this is Luke 14, verse 26. It says, if any man come to me and ate not his father and mother and wife and children and brethren and sisters, yea, and his own life also, cannot be my disciple.
Can't. So you have to disregard all these things.
Yeah.
Right, for how shall we? Because in the idea, scripture says, everything we lose upon this side, they're going to receive it
right.
100-fold, 100 times. Right?
Yes, the Lord said, declare from the beginning.
Right.
So everything where the Lord set up to happen, it's going to happen. And he made the promise that he's going to take you out of the tribulation if we have faith. See, why you can't believe that? Why you think that this Eden use against the Lord's people? Man? Especially the so-called white man today, as you bring out. See, these men know the scriptures. See? And they know the mindset of our people. And them actually put things out there and see the mindset of our people towards each other. When them start get certain things, man, so people them is a bunch of sell out. See? So these men use these things, see? They work on the mind of our people. And just like this, these men I say, boy, better way. better way to hand over to a spoil. Yeah. Sell out.
Yeah. Give over, because
give over to them.
Faith.
Instead of dropping your knees and beg for forgiveness and mercy.
Forgiveness and mercy, man. See? And whosoever doeth not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple.
Gone.
You have to bear the cross, man.
Gone. And basically, an example to you, the Lord, how Jim said, how shall use a woman to deliver Israel back then?
Right, man.
Right? Judith, at that time, and they lose, them basically lose faith, they have no faith at all because of what happened, because of them affliction and them got through, they lose faith.
Gone.
As the brother mentioned, him, so go up on the knee and beg.
But
these things written for us so we can learn today.
Yeah.
Right? Even the last minute, Heavenly Father will basically help us here.
Can. And the Lord
right, no matter.
The Lord did put shame upon them.
Can.
Shame upon them. Because he said, yo, me this. We can do anything. Anything possible. See? Yeah. We can put along in our... You have to put it the three Hebrew boys. We can put along in our fire and make it even get burned. We can get it going on fire. And not even a hair upon your head. No burn on your skin. No get touch and not even your clothes. Not have a smell of smoke or nothing like that. All the miracles the people see and hear about, and yet still some disobedient when it comes to obeying the Lord. See? It says, Ecclesiastes 2 and 1, it says, my son, if thou come to serve the Lord, prepare thy soul for temptation. See? Set thine heart aright, constantly endure, and make that ace in time of trouble.
Gone.
And these are the things that they may not do. But then, see, because even at the time of Judith, we had to bring out, I hear them making it at a time of trouble, you know. See, because they must say, boy, better we give over to them for a spoil than we die of thirst. See, I say with children, they want to make it in a time of trouble. Just be patient, man, and humble before the Lord. See? Cleave unto him and depart not away,
God,
that thou mayest be increased at thy last end.
God.
Yeah? Can I speak on it? It says, whatsoever is brought upon thee, take cheerfully,
God,
and be patient, and be patient when thou art changed to a low estate.
Can't. You're supposed to be patient. Right? No matter the situation you're going to find yourself in, you're supposed to be patient.
Can't.
As Shafar mentioned, you know, in a certain situation, you're supposed to ask yourself a question. How about Hashem Yashai? Show me how I want to learn from this situation and put me in.
Good.
Right? So the thought was supposed to, you know, have.
Right,
no, we go through certain things, certain afflictions or certain things.
Yeah. Yes, right? To get out of it.
Right.
Work it out.
Right.
Then, it says, for gold is tried in the fire, an acceptable man in the furnace of adversity.
God.
The Lord now look for no weak men. See? The Lord that choose him elect. No one weak men. See? Where's saying, sir? Hard time. Build strong men.
Yeah.
Yes. The Lord now look for no weak men, man. Because if the Lord don't want weak men, he wouldn't put you through rough times, man.
You wouldn't be men.
You wouldn't be men.
But so remember this and show yourself.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah.
Bring it again to mind.
Yeah.
The transgressors.
Yes. Right. As Blue Seed has said.
Feminine.
Yeah, as Blue Seed has said, no pray for
easy life.
Willis, yeah. Pray not for an easy life.
Yeah. But pray for strength
for
to endure.
Endurance and endure a hard one.
Yeah. That's the mindset, man.
Yep.
It's in jump to verse 10. It says, look at
the bruises on
Jake.
It says, look at the generation of old and see did. Did ever any trust in the Lord and was confounded,
God,
or did any abide in his fear and was forsaken,
God,
or who did he ever despise that call upon him?
God. So Judith, as I speak about Judith basically, they have a faith, right? So the Lord used Judith to deliver Israel, but then, right? So you have the people and we give it, we're ready to give over because of thirst.
Good.
Right? Prophets are full. Even going back during the time, Elijah.
Yeah.
Elijah Elijah basically raving the Lord, basically used to feed Elijah, but then look on Job. Job lose everything.
Gone.
Right? Even his wife turned against him. And he still never give up. Right? He still holding faith.
No, he slay me.
Yeah. Gone.
Yeah.
He said,
yeah.
Said to his wife, should he receive good at the end of the day, the father not receive bad?
Gone.
So no matter where he go to, he still holding faith. And that's basically the mindset that we're supposed to have, especially in a time like now. Because we're going to get tested on from all different sides. Right?
Yeah. And we already here, so 2023 now going to be a nice year, man. Now it'll be a nice year, man. Right. Coming to the, in a couple of years, probably if we have 2024 to come.
Hopefully we'll reach
there. Hopefully we'll reach there. It's going to get worse.
Right. Hopefully this year or the year, you know, all the prophecies come to pass. Right?
Hopefully you have all the prophecies.
God.
Yeah. This part, the Lord is full of compassion and mercy, long-suffering, and very pitiful.
Very pitiful, go on.
And forgiveth sins.
And forgiveth sins, go on.
And save it in the time of trouble.
God, and these things are always supposed to happen, you know? You know, basically, man. Because in the idea, in the time to come, we're not going to have the Bible for reader. Right? So these things, the scripture will bring out,
wisdom,
you know, for years. You know, years, but for years, we've been reading and doing lessons. Right, in the time to come, you basically, you know, can, you know, recall our mind. So remember, the scripture to tell us that these things gonna happen. Because the difference between us and Jake, the scripture don't tell us that these things gonna happen. So the time to come, when certain things start to reach us, if remember the scripture, that the first thing we're supposed to try to remember at all time, when we go through a certain situation, what the scripture say about this.
Yeah.
Right? So it says, save it, Yahweh Hashemeshai, save it in a time of affliction. God. But you have that demon that tell you, you know, if you do that, you know? Give in and do certain things because you know the flesh is weak. Yeah, so I try to tell us, you know, if you don't have to get seat at comfort, go and do this. But that's what the basic flesh always do, you.
Yeah, if you have trust in the Lord,
that's how name
represent, man. Yeah, all right. Shalom. It says, if you have trust in the Lord and faith in the Lord, man, that's how name means. Yahawashai means see him. You see him. You see him. You delivered, man. He's our savior, man.
Right.
See? It says, this is Hebrews 12:1. It says, wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which doth so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us.
Son.
Yeah. Me and thing that, man. Patience, man. The race, guys, is a race.
Paul liking being in this truth is a race.
And this is not a 100 meter dash, man. Or a 60 meter dash.
Right.
See? It's a marathon. See? You have to endure hardness.
Right.
As a good soldier, man. After Yahawashai, Amashia. See? It is looking unto Yahawashai, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of Yahweh.
So all the things that Yahweh shall go through, right, going back 2,000 years ago, in the idea Yahweh shall finish the work.
Right, man.
Right, so we're in this truth now, we have to finish our work. And no matter how much years, you know, we've been in this truth, or how much we've basically been diligent throughout the years, if we don't finish work, that don't count. Scripture tell us. Right, so all the righteousness will be forgotten.
Gone.
Right, so in the idea we finish or we started.
Gone. Right? Scripture says our light affliction is yet for a while.
But for a moment.
But for a moment, yeah? So we have to do bear that up, man. Far exceeding weight of glory. Set up. Yeah, far exceeding weight of glory. Still, the set up. The house has been a lot, man. If we are part of the hopeful elect, or if we are part of the elect when that time comes, then we have to just believe and faith. Yeah?
So with that, you know, hopefully this lesson was edifying, you know, to the elect out there, right? So with that, I say I'll praise Sanana and to Yahweh Bashemir, Shai Bashemir, Kakadash. Double honors to the apostles and to the elders of Christmas Stone. Shalom to all the brothers and all dear, you know, pushing this truth in our sincerity and in our honesty. Shalom.
Shalom.